2010, of course, was the goal that never was. And sort of, you know, you'd like to think now it would absolutely happen if we had Hawkeye.
My most famous non-goal day. When I go around the world, everyone goes, oh, that goal. What about the ones that actually went in?
Yeah. Well, it did go in.
Well, it did. You know, it certainly went in, and it obviously changed the game for the better. I think nobody could argue that goal line technology has not been a fantastic thing wherever it's used now. And I was very aware at the time it got in. I saw it bounce. Yeah, as the ball bounced, I saw it bounce and bounce out. So. It was very frustrating. Yeah, and it's very easy to draw a line over that game and say Germany absolutely, you know, beat us comfortably. That would have made it 2-2 going into half time. I hit the bar in the second half on a free kick. We had about a 15-20 minute spell where we were pushing, and then it went 3-1, game over. But it would certainly have changed the game.
Well, we were on top then. I was in the stadium that day, and we were clearly on top.
And we'd started terribly. You know, obviously 2-0 down, and we thought, oh, here we go. But Matthew Upson, I think, scored a goal, got us back in it. That would have gone 2-2 at half time. I mean, you would have fancied us a bit to come out and have a
right momentum, isn't it? The thing that happens. You know,